Hey everyone, in this numerical methods video, we're going to be talking about when the fixed point method will converge and when it will not. If you missed our previous video on the intuition behind the fixed point method, I will leave a link in the description down below for you to review that video. Okay, so how do we know if our fixed point algorithm is going to converge or diverge from our fixed point? Meaning, under which situations will our error be increasing? Which is diverging, we are diverging or moving away from our fixed point, or converging, closing in on our point of interest. Well, if we think about it some, there is a pattern that makes sense. I think that this is best shown through an example of simple straight lines, but the same applies for more difficult functions as well. Let's look at these two g of x functions here. In scenario 1, we have a constant sloping g of x function that is greater than 1. If we apply the fixed point method visually, we choose some starting point, evaluate the function at that point, then move to our output equals input line, and then continue in this manner. As you can see here, this is never going to converge to our fixed point, as our slope of g of x in absolute terms is greater than 1. So we will always diverge from our fixed point. Now, let's look at scenario 2, where a slope of g of x is always less than 1. Choosing any starting guess, it becomes clear that we will always be converging to our fixed point. So, what does this tell us? Well, we can state that our fixed point method will converge if the absolute value of our g of x's derivative function remains under 1. Within a given interval around our fixed point, then we are guaranteed convergence on our root. So, now that we have a better understanding of our fixed point method's convergence criteria, let's look at another example. Here we have g of x minus x cubed minus 3. As you can see, no matter what initial guess we use, we cannot get our fixed point method to converge. Well, why is that? Remember how when we were defining convergence, we stated that the statement had to be true within a given interval. Well, no matter how small our interval is, if the absolute value of the slope of the tangent of our fixed point is larger than 1, then our function can never converge, as you can see here. So, no matter how good our starting guess is, if our function's slope is greater than 1, evaluated at our root of interest, divergence will occur. So, as you can see here, the root of our function's instantaneous rate of change is minus 1.52, which, in absolute terms, is larger than 1, and why convergence is not possible. We would therefore need to use another root-solving method for this problem. I hope that this video helped your understanding of convergence criteria in the fixed point method. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.